Hi guys, welcome back to ThinkView. The LG Gram has been well known in the laptop world for many years. Users think of it as an ultra-light laptop, and that's reminded right in its name, Gram. When this first came out, the thick, large, meaty gaming laptops were still very popular on the market. Then came a breath of fresh air. The LG Gram hits right at users' demands for a thin and super light laptop for ultra portability. And it was a hit. It became a very popular laptop line till this day. Today I have the latest 14-inch and 15-inch LG Grams in 2020 right in front of me. Let's see if they still have the magic. The first thing that impressed me as soon as I lay my hands on these machines are still that they're so light. The 14-inch version is only 994 grams, and the 15-inch is another 100 grams, so 1.1 kilograms. Very lightweight. For example, this 14-inch version, compared to the 13-inch XPS, it has a larger screen size and weighs 200 grams less. But it's actually not the lightest laptop in 2020. Many names have surpassed it in terms of lightness, such as the Asus Swift 7, Asus ExpertBook B9, or Samsung Galaxy Book S. But the interesting thing is, when thinking of the lightest laptop, I bet most people still think of the LG Gram. Very good marketing from LG, isn't it? Okay, if it's just lightweight, then it wouldn't be that special, right? Clearly, it wouldn't be the only reason why you want to buy this machine. The LG Gram is a premium laptop line, so there's a lot of things to talk about. First, let's talk design. There are things that I'm impressed with, but also things that disappoint me in this 2020 model. This uses nanocarbon magnesium alloy material to mix for the lightweight and durability. To the touch, it feels completely different to laptops made of aluminum magnesium or magnesium carbon fiber alloy. Its surface is more matte, great to the touch, and very resistant to sweat and fingerprints. It's a great thing to have to preserve this pristine white that I have in the 14-inch version here. But there are also some pretty disappointing things. I think for a premium laptop, this machine has a pretty cheap-looking design. I bet if you show this to someone who's completely clueless about tech, they wouldn't tell you that this starts at $1,200 for the 14-inch version. From the thick bezels to the patchy details to the tiny touchpad, there's very little that screams premium about this design. It's 2020. Why is the lower bezel still so thick? And of course, the particular material means that it appears quite plasticky and cheap. Other than that, the LG Gram is notorious for its flexes. Look at this. Looks like I'm bending the whole keyboard frame. You can feel it a little when typing too. It doesn't feel particularly stable. It's almost like it's hollow inside. Of course, this is just due to the material. The LG Gram is a highly durable machine with the MIL-STD standard. But still, this adds to the cheap look and feel compared to aluminum-based ultrabooks. Another notable change in this year's Gram is the hinge. The two-joint hinge from last year got criticized for being a bit weak, not being able to support the display very well. So this year, LG switched back to the long one-piece hinge. It has a great one-hand opening and closing feel, light and even false, and it can hold still at almost any angle. Open it up. The 14-inch has a pretty compact layout and I prefer it to the 15-inch, also because I don't use the numpad. But to me, the keycaps could have been bigger if LG had reduced the gaps between them and utilized the outside space. The tab, shift, and backspace keys are also smaller than usual. While the lowest row is suddenly taller than the rest, anyway, my mistyping rate seems to be a little bit higher on this one than with premium laptops these days, like the XPS's, ThinkPads, or MacBooks. Other than that, typing feel is good, better than last year at least. It's steadier and feels more satisfying. The keyboard has a black and white tone, with orange highlights at the function and arrow keys. I like this, it looks vibrant and youthful. The power button is equipped with a fingerprint sensor, but it looks really patchy. Too many details, sacrificing the clean look of the design. I also don't know why it sinks down compared to the rest of the keyboard. Again, not the best design decision here. The touchpad is really small for today's standard. The surface has a plasticky feel and quickly gets sticky with sweat. When this happens, it doesn't have the best accuracy, and overall, it feels like I always have to try a bit harder to track accurately on this touchpad, so my fingers get tired faster, possibly also because of the size. It's also slanted downwards quite a bit and produces this sound when clicking, which I never liked. Display quality is really, really nice for a Full HD panel, one of the best that I've ever got to experience. Possibly because this is an LG made panel, so they can better optimize it for their devices. This uses a glass panel. Colors are crystal clear and very satisfying to look at. Well calibrated out of the box too. Sharpness is also on point. Everything looks great on this display, and numbers can't even do it justice. So, you can comfortably buy this for basic 2D graphics work. The speakers do get quite loud, making the body vibrate a little at high volumes, but it's nothing special of a speaker system. Still your typical Ultrabook sound, very little bass. With laptops like this, I almost always use my Bluetooth headphones. The I/Os are good, USB-A, HDMI, and Thunderbolt 3. The 15-inch version has 3 USB-As, while the 14-inch only has 2. Both versions have a microSD card slot. I would usually prefer a full-size one, but there are now microSD cards with really high read and write speeds and good capacity too, so this would come in handy if you're using one of those. About performance, Intel Core i5-1035G7 CPU, integrated Intel Iris Plus graphics, 8GB of RAM and 256GB SSD. A very standard spec for you to study and work, for the most part. The latest Intel Ice Lake accommodates basic demands really well. No need to be concerned about it. 2D graphic designing, color grading raw images are now much more comfortable. I do a lot of raw editings, real-time color gradings, and it's real comfortable on this machine. For entertaining demands, the Iris Plus graphics allows you to play basic games like CSGO or League of Legends comfortably at low settings. Like many other products nowadays, the LG Gram also comes with the integrated LG Control Center app. Here, you can adjust the fan and it works quite well. The fans really spin when you put it to max. For an office laptop, I don't know if this feature is really necessary, but if you need it, it works. Other than that, it also allows you to quickly turn on and off some other functions like charging through USB-C or limiting the maximum charging percentage to increase battery longevity. Quite nice. The last special thing about the LG Gram is battery. For very lightweight machines, both the 14-inch and 15-inch versions have a very decent battery capacity at 72 watt-hours. 72 watt-hours on a laptop designed to be power efficient is no joke. You can use this continuously for way over 10 hours. Sometimes it would even last me almost 2 whole work days. I hardly ever care about charging when I'm using this. It's very good for business people who have to travel a lot. To conclude on the LG Gram in 2020, there are things that are still good on it, like the display, I/Os, and long battery life. There are also things that have been improved, like the hinge and typing feel. But for the price of a premium machine, I can't help but think that the Gram is lacking some magic. The magic that once came from the lightest title, the thing that wows people about it, is no longer there, because it's not the lightest machine anymore. But it seems like LG is still relying a lot on the famous Gram name and hope that it would still be the selling point, instead of focusing on improving their machine to keep up with the numerous competitors in the ultra-portable category. It's definitely time for a design overhaul. Everything from the bezels to the keyboard layout and touchpad, if they want to maintain their foothold in a very competitive laptop market. That's it for today. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Please subscribe and follow us on social media to get the latest update and show your support. Also, comment below your request for reviews and we'll try our absolute best to accommodate them. Bye for now!